Kenneth Burke developed his communication studies theory of dramatism as a way to interpret and explain the human motivation behind action and thought. His theory was inspired by William Shakespeare's quote that states, "All the world's a stage, and all the men and women merely players." With this theory, Burke argues that by taking a dramatic approach to the interpretation of communicative modes, we can answer the question, what are people doing and why are they doing it? As written in his book, A Grammar of Motives, the core of Burke's theory of dramatism is what he refers to as the dramatic pentad. With this concept in mind, Burke argues that any complete statement about human motives in relation to the analysis of a text or an image will offer some kind of answer to the following questions. What was done? When or where it was done? Who did it? How he did it? And why? These five questions were interpreted to create the five elements of Burke's dramatic pentad, as we can see here. The dramatic pentad is one element of the rhetorical strategy of visual dramatism, which allows us to interpret images under Burke's innovative theory of dramatism. Let's take a closer look at how these elements function in relation to images. Here we have an image of a girl that is looking into a cauldron. By using Burke's dramatic pentad, we can better understand what is happening. The first element of the pentad is the act, or what took place. In this image, the act is making a potion. Next is the scene, or the background or situation in which the act occurred. Here the scene is the potion's classroom. The next element is agent, or what person performed the act. The agent in this image is Hermione Granger, a student at Hogwarts School for Witchcraft and Wizardry. Now we must look at the agency, or what means or instruments were used to complete the act. In this image, the agency is the supplies and ingredients used to make the potion. The final element of the pentad is the purpose, which analyzes why the act took place. In this situation, the purpose behind the act of making the potion was to complete a class assignment. By using the dramatic pentad as a mode of analysis, we now have a better understanding of what is happening in the image. It is possible that individuals can interpret elements of the pentad differently, which may lead to different explanations of actions based on one's personal beliefs. One individual may applaud this young witch on her hard work and dedication to completing her assignment, while another individual may interpret her actions as nothing more than a silly muggle attempting to boil a pot of noodles. But a complete analysis of Burke's dramatic pentad can better help us get to the root of her motivation for action. If we were to continue an analysis of the image in accordance to visual dramatism, we would eventually be able to make a statement about the larger ideologies revealed by our observation of the image and what this may say about beliefs about human nature and society. As Burke consistently reminds us, life is a drama, and when we analyze communicative modes as such, we can develop a deeper understanding for the motivation of human action.